Whether you take the decision to keep doing business, to keep dealing with this bank, or to shift for another bank, there are many strategies. You have to adopt some strategies that you shouldn't leave, you shouldn't think about them even for a while. Okay, they should be part of your relationship with this bank. One of the most important things that also many of the other strategies will be around this strategy is the being proactive and transparent. Proactive and transparent, honestly speaking, for a bank, always it's being there in the mind of the customer that if the bank knows anything that is negative about me, the bank will stop my facilities. The bank will not do business with me. The bank will start pushing on me to settle and whatever problem. In general, a relationship, when we talk about relationship, and I believe it is not only about relationship, it is about partnership. Both the bank and the customer, they are partners. If you are coming back to me from the beginning, telling me that I may face a problem after 2 weeks or 3 weeks, at least let's think about it in this way, that I may help you and I may support you. But if I have it all of a sudden that you have a problem, you have past dues, you have whatever, an issue, for sure I will not be helpful for you as if you come to me earlier. So being proactive is very important, and being transparent also very important. Transparency here, what we mean with transparency, that please do not try to hide anything from the bank. There are many ways, many things that the bank will find out the truth, will reach to the truth, even if you don't give it to the bank. So make it simple for you and the bank, being proactive and transparent. The other thing is that keep them in the loop about your pipeline and your wins. This is the same thing about the first point, but here, whatever is going on, for us as a bankers, it will be much easier to plan for you, to be on your side. We have many cases that we said to the customers that this is the maximum that we can go ahead. But there are some customers who are keeping us in the view of every development that they are going through, okay, of their wins, of their ups and downs. All of this update for the bank, it's giving us the opportunity sometimes to support them, to support the customers even above the limits that we can go with. Share with the bank the good news that you may have. In case there is any kind of press, just ask yourself, does this press about our business, does it deserve to share it with the bank? If it deserves, just ask yourself, does this information deserve to share with the bank? Please immediately share it. I keep saying I'm a strong believer in the terminology of partnership and relationship. It is a relationship, it is not a transactional. Even for those transactions, there are many transactions, there are many relationships in the banks, they are being done through one transaction. We have it, mainly through maybe the retail, even through the SMEs. Now there's a lot of relationships which are being done through one transaction, and the customer will start paying off the amount of this transaction over maybe 3 years or 4 years. Even though, don't think about it that when I need the bank, I will communicate, I will talk to the bank. No, please keep in touch, keep the relationship with the bank. Don't think of it as just a transaction. Facility reviews should be handled like a new application for finance. This is one of the major issues that we are facing with SMEs. Some of the SMEs, they believe that, okay, we will prepare this, we will do this at the beginning because they asked for it, the bank, at the beginning. Khalas, after that, we will not prepare it. Some of the customers, they are preparing financials, audited financials, just for the purpose of getting a finance of one transaction. This is not the correct thing. Doing a financial, okay, it will not affect the bank. Because if you don't make the financials for the banks, in many banks, they will not give you the finance. It will help you to monitor your business. It will give you the good picture about your business. Where are you today? Where you should be tomorrow? What are the results of your business? All of the requirements in terms of documentation, financials, bank statements, it should be done and it should be provided on every review, whether it is semi-annually or annually. Meet all of your obligations. Here, when we talk about obligations, we are not talking only about the banking obligations or financial obligations. There are non-bank obligations and there are non-financial obligations. Now, we normally, one of the most important sentences that we mention in our credit applications, we normally prepare a credit application and we submit it to the committee for their approvals. One of the main things that we mention under our SWOT analysis is the strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats analysis. Under the SWOT, we mention that this customer never shown any irregularities. This customer never been in default, never been in past dues. Routing business income to the bank. The owner, he will not commit with any, he will not give any commitment unless he is 100% sure that he will fulfill his commitment. This is the important things when we talk about meeting obligations. This is an important parameter for us to take a decision about the customer or not. The non-bank obligations could be the salaries of the customer employees, maybe the payments for his suppliers. This is something not related to my bank, not related to the bank. But if we have an indication or an information that this customer is not paying his staff salaries, this is a big issue for the customer. Non-financial, sometimes we put conditions on the customer to provide us of a kind of reporting. Please do not consider any of the conditions. Read your facility offer letters very well. Whatever a condition that is not clear, that doesn't make sense, ask the bank to waive it. Because there are some banks, I believe that they are adding some conditions which are not making any sense. So you have to understand, it is not a kind of a cliche, the approval. It has conditions. Some of the conditions, we reach to a level that sometimes we cancel the facilities of the customers because they have not met a non-financial condition. For example, reporting. I need to have a reporting about the progress in a specific project or in a specific line of business, but the customer is not providing us with. We will take it in a way that the customer either he is not aware of his business well, he cannot provide us with, or he's trying to hide it. Please, please avoid surprises. Don't come all of a sudden that Hamad X Bank, sorry, we need to postpone our installment for the next 6 months. When the due date of the installment? Yesterday. So after being in past dues, you are asking to postpone. This is honestly one of the worst things to give the bank, is to give him a negative surprise. We are happy to have any positive surprises, but please don't make it negative. If you have any problem, share it with the bank from the beginning. Don't leave it to the end. Like any relationship in this world, whatever you will put into it, you will get out of it. So don't expect that if you are hiding information from me, that if you are not transparent, if you are not delivering what we need, okay, that you will get the full support of the bank and you will get the help that you are expecting.